district case that Ontario is unique among provinces in having an appeal organization, the Ontario Municipal Board. I think it's about 100 years old, and originally was formed to enforce the Railway Act. However, for those of us that try hard to maintain our neighborhoods, we are forever undermined by the Ontario Municipal Board as we try to make sure that we can maintain our neighborhoods. I'd like to hear from each of you what your party's policy may be in terms of reforming the Ontario Municipal Board, or indeed getting rid of it.
Mr. Marchese, you're up.
I remember Mike Cole, the member from Eglinton Lawrence, the Liberal member, saying, in fact, I introduced a bill that said we should get rid of the OMB. I happen to agree with that. I'm not sure how we reform the OMB, but I was planning on introducing a bill to make sure that the OMB does not have powers over the City of Toronto. The City of Toronto has incredible municipal powers and is very mature enough that it doesn't need the OMB to tell them how much higher they can or cannot build. The City of Toronto should be able to decide that. And what happens is the city, as you know, says no to a certain limit of density. They go to the MB immediately now because they know they can bypass the City of Toronto and they get, on the whole, what they want. So it was difficult to do that bill because they told me that they would have to change hundreds of bills, and so it was difficult to get the language. And they said it might not stand out in court. But my view is, let's get the OMB out of any city that doesn't want oversight over their affairs. At least that's something we can do. But my view is, if we get rid of the OMB, it would be great. And then
we'll see. Well, having read from Mayor Toronto, I must say I agree with Rosario. I think we have to move forward, and I think there are a lot of, I have seen it, there are a lot of developers that just run over the OMB, and we have to get more representation, stronger representation of communities there. So I will work towards that. I believe it's very, very important. We need to, if we were to look at reforming it, how would you reform it? I don't have the answers to that. Cut it exactly. So do we have to get rid of it? I think there are cities in Toronto that do have a good official plan, and they can move that official plan forward. But I really think it does need to, it's old legislation that we need to review.
Thank you. Mr. Grant.
Well, let me go a little different direction. I too think that the OMB needs to be curtailed, but our party platform is it needs to be reformed. Here's the distinction here. The OMB deals with, I think even in our own neighborhood of the Harvard Village, over the last 5 years, we had about 8 or 10 local, and I've talked about many OMB appeals. And so it's an issue of scale, and then yet you've got larger issues where the City of Toronto is appealing to the OMB, or major developers have run to the OMB to get a major development through. So it's on the issue of we think we want to get the OMB out of the small neighborhoods with the small issues, and that's 3/4 of the cases of the OMB. But we think that it's important that the city, because a lot of cities abdicate on planning responsibilities. Councillors decide they're not going to take a position, or they hear from neighbors and decide they're not going to have affordable housing in a neighborhood, and it goes to the OMB. We think it's actually not a bad thing. In that limited 25% of the work that the OMB currently does, to retain those powers, to be a second voice, and so therefore we would retain it in a much diminished capacity.